Don't let the sun go down on me, you guys. Capricorn, I apologize. I've been fucking around with the resolution on this setup that I have, and it's not doing me any good. I'm just going to push through, though. I just heard I am the laziest girl in town. I don't know if that has anything to do with you goats, but I did have your What's Happening cards. I'm doing a special spread. It's going to tell me what's happening with you guys during this eclipse season. I'm starting to see a theme, though, with everybody. Those candles back there have been on ever since I started recording, which I'm 4 days in now. So I'm releasing you and Taurus video, and I hope they last through Pisces. I think they will. They've been literally on nonstop for 5 days. I think I've started on the first or the second. I think I started on the second or the third. Yeah, second. I think I started on the second or the third. Let me turn this off. I do have the sun gods playing in the background just so that I can make moves like Mick Jagger. Shit. That's what the song is. My mouth may not be running right to the tape and all that stuff, but it's just weird, you guys. And I'm sorry. I'm going to really have to spend some time and fucking figure this shit out. But anyways, what's happening with you guys? I got two cards. One of them I wasn't sure about, but this one came out. This card came out for you guys, and it says, a new world is born. So for you Capricorns, some of you Capricorns, this is happening during the eclipse month. That is awesome and great for you. And the other one is the Mermaid of Immersion, which is complete commitment. Okay, so whatever's happening, you know, we're going to find out. I'm going to start with your money, though. And I'm going to turn moves like Mick Jagger down for I'll be dancing. I am Jupiter's Law. For those that don't know, now you know. If you're new to me, I have a ton of videos out to tell you about me. I was trying to explain how this YouTube can make you very narcissistic and just very kind of like all the things that I really detest. But it is what it is. So Capricorn, your money section, I'm kind of down because I had a conversation with my BFF. And, you know, in Taurus, I kind of got a little razzle-dazzle as I was talking about all the things that I endured. And I've put them all past me, and I am putting them all past me. I have a lot of videos out about that ordeal. So if people are like, what are you talking about? What is she talking about? Well, what I should have said is instead of telling people what they did and, you know, you did this, you did that. And maybe this is a message for you guys, Capricorn, because this is the second time I said, damn, your cards are falling the fuck out, which is great. Ugh. The Emperor, okay? Now, that's probably for my ass. Let me put these cards down while I'm talking. That's definitely for me. Capricorn, I was just saying how when you tell people how they made you feel versus what they did, how the impact, you get to own yourself, and then you can walk away and you're not looking for the reaction from the person. So when I first started, you know, people was just coming at me, coming for me, you know, left and right. And really, Jupiter's Law is my alter ego, because outside of this, when I come on, when the camera's rolling, I'm very shy. I'm kind of uncomfortable in front of cameras. I don't like to be watched. I don't like to be filmed. You guys will not have no naked videos of me getting leaked out to no boyfriends, no sexy pictures. I'm just like very private when it comes to myself because I'm a very powerful person. So when I'm on, people can really feel me most of the time, right? I have water and fire in my chart like nobody's business. But I do have a Capricorn and Venus, you guys. Anyways, what I wanted to say is, you know, I said a lot of shit about how I felt attacked and how I felt. You know, people, I don't even like to use the word hate, and I don't even use that term in my, you know, conversations with people, because I just feel like I'm at a level, put it like this, Jupiter's Law is my alter ego, okay? This is the space I created to just kind of have some of my personality, but as a woman and as a mother, you know, I tend to carry myself with a high regard. And sometimes when I'm on with you guys, I don't say the things that are most beneficial with you guys. I bullshit, I jaw jack. You know, I like to have a good time when I'm here, at least. However, when you tell people, you know, I was telling people like, oh, this person did this, this person did that, she did this, this person clowned like this, this person did that. But really, when you sit back, because I am a pretty mature person, pretty evolved, when you tell people like, hey, you know, I felt hurt, you know, and I felt demeaned and I felt humiliated. And, you know, that really made me feel like, you know, some of the other tarot readers that I've either had readings with or that I consider myself being friends with them, you know, I kind of went out, you know, I went out, y'all, and I'm over it now because now I see it for what it is. And I see people for who they are. And there's nothing wrong with that. You know, that's not no shade. That's not when you see things for what they are and you can just sit back and just tell people like, hey, you know, that hurt me. And, you know, I was hurt by that because I didn't do anything to deserve that. And, you know, when I came on, you know, I came on with this Kumbaya, let us love each other. And I saw that in the spirit world and the esoteric world and tarot readers, everybody ain't like that. And, you know, it's about a lot of shit that I'm not about, you know, turf and money and just whatever. But what I'm saying is what I'm trying to convey once again with my long-winded ass is that sometimes when you step back, instead of pointing out what a person did and how they made you feel, it keeps you attached to those emotions. Because in Taurus, I kind of wild out a little bit. And I didn't mean to, but maybe I'll edit some of that shit out because I'm over it. But when you really tell people like, hey, you know, it made me feel like this or it made me feel like that, you get to own your feelings and you can walk away without looking for, you know, an answer from that person. You just own how you felt and you be done with that shit. So I'm done with that shit. So anyway, Capricorn, I am Jupiter's law. I love everybody. I truly do. Let's see what's going on in your money sector. Because right now it seems like a new world is being born for you. And so if that's what's up with you guys during the season and you need to be make a complete commitment to the new world that's being born with you, Capricorn, that's what's up. So let's check out your money. The sun's going down, you guys. I got to do Pisces. This video, when I say Pisces, the cards are out. So let's see what's going on with your money. Budget lessons. Bam. Spirit is still here with me. That's very good. Usually the spirit is here with me. I'm learning how to hone my power. You guys have budget lessons. I want to say what I see here, what's happening with you guys and your budget lessons. If you've made a commitment to somebody or something, or you just had a baby, yeah, you probably got some budget. Health. Release the past, decadent indulgence. I don't know what that's for, but I'll pull them out. Well, damn, Capricorn. All right, then. Y'all falling the fuck out. Faith. You got a heavy hitter. Let's see what's going on with your health. When I said baby, I don't know, you guys. Let me see what's going on, Cappy. Sometimes I feel a little disconnected in the readings when I start, and then I feel better as it go on. But since this is fall the fuck out, I want y'all to fall the fuck out. You know what I mean? Your cards, fall the fuck out. Because the spirit is heavy for me. See? Damn it. And you know what? This card fell out when I was shuffling earlier, you guys. So I know this is for you. All right. So look, you got the moon card here. You got unexpected help. So I'm feeling a heavy vibe of a lot of expecting mothers, Capricorn. I was working on health. Let me get your love. I was feeling a really heavy spirit about mothers, babies, births, a new world, a commitment to something. The hangman. Let me get your love. And then I'm going to do something for singles and for people in relationships. And I'm going to try and use all the energy here. I didn't want to do a lot of talking because now I'm starting to wear down, you guys. I actually started recording on the 2nd. And I have this new equipment. And it's crazy. Capricorn, your love. So, I'm going to see how... Ooh. The High Priestess in reverse. Are you not listening to your intuition? All right. And the Hermit. On the bottom. Let me see if I can get another love for Capricorns. Yeah, it's the Hermit. That's what's up. And Temperance. You're trying to balance. Okay, I'm done. And you know what? I'm sorry, y'all, but I gotta pee. Shit. Gotta pee. I'm gonna have to wait. I got health issues. Gotta pee, y'all. Volume up really high. I hope you guys can't hear that. You're tinkling. Well, at least you know I really do gotta go, and I wasn't playing. And unfortunately, Capricorn. Yeah. Somebody said she get out like that. Yeah, get out like that. I do. I have to. Or I wouldn't be able to do this, y'all, if I didn't get down like that. Right? It just, when you're here with me, you just got to be here with me. If you're new, welcome. Welcome, new people. But that's how I get down. Like, you know, I'm in my bed. I started these sessions in my bed. And that's where they're going to end up because, you know, that's the way I needed to get down. So I don't know if I'll always get down, but you can subscribe. And when you show up, you just be here. We just here. So, yeah, that's how I get down. For that person that said that, damn, she get down like that. Yes. Everybody's unique. Everybody got their own way of doing shit. Check this out, goat people. My goaters. You know, y'all got some real major arcanas. You got the moon and the faith card, okay? So I do see a little bit of a mixed bag. A lot of people have mixed bags. You guys got the hermits upright and the high priestess in reverse. So since I was talking and I'm doing your money, health, love, and relationship, let me look at this evidence and see if I can get where I feel these issues are impacting you or affecting you the most, because I do feel like there is something that's trying to be told. And I just want to see if I can get this. Budget lessons came out with your money. So if something's born and you made a complete commitment to something, health was decadence and indulgence, which is actually the Seven of Cups. Release the past and change. You got unexpected help and the Hermit card and the High Priestess in reverse and the Fool card and the Moon card. Woohoo! I thought this was going to be easy. I thought you guys were going to be easy, but you know what? I really do feel like some mothers, there's some people that are going through some depression. As even though this New World card is here, and this is what's really your overall, what's happening with you, there's a lot of blue sticking out. And I feel like some people are going through some depression. And some people are going within themselves, yearning and desiring for something. Some people are released in the past. Some people, yeah, some of you guys are being affected by the eclipse, like most people that I've seen since I've been doing the sessions. Because I have this moon card here, and this lady is like wrapped up. I'm so sorry, you guys, for how shitty it may be looking. She's wrapped up. She's in a cocoon. I'm sorry, that was the moon card. But here's the hermit card. The same thing is here. Okay? And then I have the release the past and change. I feel like these three have something to do with each other. And I don't really know what. Because you got some unexpected help, but you got budget lessons. So this is what I'm thinking. This may have something to do with your relationship. I'm going to do couples and singles, so don't worry. I think this might, unexpected help, this six, whatever it is, six of coins probably. You know, I think you guys might have a partnership that's helping you out now. Oh, God, you guys, I am totally fucking stumped. The High Priestess in reverse definitely fell out when I was talking about your love life. Feminine influence and inner guidance. You know, you could be yielding to a man that's in your life. I'm just going to have to jump around with y'all, but we just going to have to make it do what it do, because these are all major. High Priestess, the Hermit, the Moon. Something will hit you guys. And the Fool card. Let me just go here. I feel like there's a woman that's running from an abusive relationship that she was in. She's getting out. She finally said, I'm not going to be the fool no more. And while she's getting out, she's dealing with this. She's going within. She's realizing what she did. And I still think that this person, woman, male or female, mostly female. I hate that word, female, woman. I'm getting a woman strongly. I feel like this woman is still thinking about, but I feel like she's turning away from the abuse, and I feel like somebody is, all these women have the same action, okay? Release the past and changes here. It was either with your love or your health. So either or, considerably, because you got the Seven of Cups here. Yeah, there's definitely some illusions, or you guys are stumping the fuck out of me. I'm not going to even lie. Probably because the way the cards was falling out, it just was kind of like out of order. And now I'm having to really use my gifts to see. Definitely am getting a story of a person that's leaving an abusive situation. As far as your health concern, I feel like your health can be impacted by your finances. I'm not picking up much other than some Capricorns are concerned about their weight. And I know that's been a theme with you guys in the past. Some Capricorns can be concerned, especially their lower body. You know, some Capricorn rules the knees, I believe, astrologically. Every astrological sign rules a part of the body. Taurus is the throat. Capricorn is the knees because Sagittarius is hips and thighs. Hips by area. You guys are the knees. With your health, because money, you got budget lessons. I don't need to talk about that very much. I feel like the budget lessons might be due to a relationship, though, or giving away too much money, or people expecting for you to give them money, or these women are just calling my name, the Fool, the Moon, the Hermit, and the Release the Past. They're all women. So let me just go to your health real quick. I feel like some of you guys could be, if not having knee problems, yeah, I do feel like you guys are having some knee problems. Some of you guys are having some knee problems, women or men. And some of you guys may be running and jogging and working out. And some of you guys may drink or could be trying to stop drinking with your health. And because drinking can put weight on you, because I'm seeing the weight around here, like hips and thighs, like a Sag. So I believe that some of you guys could be trying to work off your butt or your thighs, but your knees could be bothering you. And so, you know, that could make it hard to run and jog and do shit that you want to do. Because I'm definitely seeing the legs, the calves, and the knees. The unexpected help, as far as your love life, unexpected help, whoever that woman is or man is leaving an abusive relationship, I feel like you have some help. I feel like you have a sister or somebody that's helping you get out of an abusive relationship, because you're definitely ready to do that. And you definitely have some healing to do. Okay. So back to your health. There's definitely the Hermit card. Some people are going in, and yet, you know, I used to be put it like this. I did some short-term counseling for battered women. And so I know the dynamics of, you know, still loving your abuser, quote unquote, you know, how that is to have to deal with those conflicting feelings. So if a woman is feeling that way, don't feel bad. It's normal. It's part of the process. It's the abuse cycle, you know, there's stages. And so if you just recently left someone who's had you, you know, controlling you and abusive to you, that doesn't mean that you don't love them. That just means that was an unhealthy relationship that you shouldn't have been in, but you still may be yearning and desiring from them. And that's making you depressed because you're questioning yourself, saying, why do I still love somebody who beat me? Or why did I love somebody who, you know, was mean to me? That's just part of the cycle of abuse. And, you know, we need to lighten up about that shit, because I've been in some abusive relationship. I didn't stay too long, but the time that I stayed, it was unhealthy and it made me feel some kind of way. Shit. I was wondering why I still love that person. Well, it's a cycle, and I'm not about to get all off into that. So you're just going to have to go through the throes, but know that you're not turning back and that you shouldn't turn back. This lady doesn't look like she wants to go back. She looks like she's over it. So be over it. And this lady looked like she definitely ran from it. The Fool card says spontaneity and taking chances. Okay. Release your past. You know, do the best that you can. Now, your love, the High Priestess is in reverse. What I'm getting, though, for your love, overall, I'm going to do relationships as single, is that somehow you could be in a relationship where the unexpected help, you're not getting the help that you want from your partner, mainly with the finances, the house, somebody's not helping you pay half, of the bills. The income is not coming in like you want. The person's not giving back like they should. This is upright, but with the high priest is in reverse, I'm kind of sensing with your love life, don't be the fool, even though the fool is about faith and taking chances. Sometimes you can take chances that you shouldn't be taking. I feel like the fool is related to your love life as well, because I just kind of feel like you're in a relationship. You've gotten into a relationship with somebody where you're completely committed, you know, but maybe your partner isn't committed. And I don't really want to say how. So let me go into the people that are in a relationship and see what's going on. I also see this wolf moon, little wolf moon, wolf girl. It's all right to be alone. Some of you guys that are just, this is here. This was on the bottom of your deck. And this is what be what's happening. The moon is here. So the moon is very significant to you guys. I would be very careful during the eclipse and the full moon that's coming on the 16th. You guys, you see the moon? You see the moon? Well, she's in reverse. And I'm reading my reversals, by the way, when they come in, as if this is the issue that you're having. Not that you're trying to come out of it, but this is what's startling you. So some of you guys are feeling very alone, which is definitely prevalent visually in the moon card, the yearning and desire, and also the hermit card. The little wolf girl is saying it's okay to be alone. Some of you guys already talked about the new mothers. I do believe there's some babies being born. There's too much feminine energy here. Anyways, and you could also not be getting help from your partner if you got a new baby. Your partner could like not be letting you sleep and you're not just getting what you need. But let me go into relationships. I feel like I'm low on my relationship cards. There's not very many here, but feels like some is missing. Let me see if I can do a quick check. Capricorn on these numbers. Everybody here. Yeah, everybody here. You guys, I'm sorry. This new setup, I cannot stop my video and pause it and then come back to you guys. So you guys just have to, you got to hang in there because that's what's up for right now. I'm recording and I don't have a pause button on this program that I'm using. So anyway, this is for those that are in relationships where you may be being a fool, or you may have taken a chance, or you may have left a relationship and got out of it. You may not be getting the help that you need out of your relationship, and you're not using your intuition, or you could be, once again, the abusive relationship is coming up. But this card that I'm going to pull is definitely for those that are in relationships. And that means one where you think you're the only person in it and that other person is the only person in it. Not think, but supposed to be. So whether it's marriage, you know, you guys are cheating. That's not what I'm focusing on. With this, I'm focusing on the one-on-one relationships that you're having. Whatever the cards say, that is what I'm going to tell you about that relationship. So if you're supposed to be married, Capricorn, or you're married to a Capricorn. Hold on, that just popped out. Are you married to a Capricorn and they're cheating? That's not what I'm focusing on. Yeah. So I got your cards. This one fell down, coyness. I don't know if it was upright or in reverse. Coyness. On this picture, there's a woman and a guy is like painting her and she's naked. And then submission came in. So absolutely. I feel like what I said earlier with the abusive relationship and submission. For those in a relationship, I don't know how they came out because this one fell on the ground. The coyness fell on the ground. But if you look at this card, I hope you guys can see it. I'm going to really focus in until I think you guys can see it. Submission. Somebody's getting their ass whooped into shape. Okay, whether it's you, female, or male Capricorn, I don't know. But the woman is whooping, the boy is whooping the woman, and she looking like, what? This may be for my people who fled abusive relationships. If you haven't, you probably should. Nobody wants to get their ass whooped. Because this also came out coyness, and I think it came out reverse. That's what I'm feeling, which means there's a man who is kind of like painting a woman, and the woman's like half naked, but she's covering her honeypot. Like, I don't really want you to get that. So somebody can be, I'm going to interpret this two ways. Abusive relationship for sure, where somebody just wants you to be fucking submissive to them. Okay. Because there's all this feminine energy here with these fool cards and the other cards. And then it's like, this comes out for those in relationship. If you're in a relationship, you could either be whipping your mate into submission or your mate wants to whip you into submission some kind of way. I'm not going to say if it's negative or good, because somebody definitely is getting out of an abusive relationship or not. Damn, what the fuck was, what was that? Everything just went dark. Did you guys see that? Okay, let me hurry up because this setup that I got, I don't know what is going to happen or why. Oh my God, hold on you guys. Fuck. That's not cool. Let me make sure everything's connected. I'm still here, but I don't want shit to go bad. Okay, I turned on my light. So listen, Cappy, listen. So the coyness could be, if you're in a good relationship, you know, and everything's cool, you know, you guys could be doing some role playing. You could be having a man paint pictures of you naked and you're like, no, babe, you can't get that. And you could be with an artist and you're like, baby, no, look, you cannot have my goodies on there. And they're like, baby, please. And you're like, no. And they're like, you have to let me do this. You're going to look like a statue of good coochie. They want to, you know, push you a little further. You know, you could have a person that is truly an artist and they just want to take you a little further. And you just kind of like, I ain't with it. And that could also be sexually, you know, just like, I'm not with it. But I am getting that there's still some dominant energy, like, you know, dominant and a person like, I don't want to have that kind of relationship with you. Sorry about the glare, y'all. I'm not going to keep apologizing. This is fucked. You know, I'm just going to have to do better because it's bothering me. I really don't like to get down like this. There's not much I can do. And I want these videos to be out because I have Pisces. And then I'm dying, you guys. And then I have to figure out how and if I'm going to be able to come back in October. I got to finish my spiritual journey this month because it's heavy. All right, let's go to you singles. My single Capricorn. What and how is it going to be coming in for y'all? I can see that glare and it's killing me. And it kills me. To know how much I love you. Give each other space came out, but I think that's for you you people that are in those kind of relationships that ain't really cool. Give each other space came out. So since I've gotten closer to the camera, there's the coyness. Someone's asking me what cards I'm using. I don't know the name of this deck because I don't have the book out. I only have the book out for two of them, and my bed and my room's been like this since I started filming, but you guys can see the submission. I know you can see that a little better. Yeah, something's up with that. But anyway, single Capricorns, give each other space came in reverse. So if you're in a relationship right now, you know, and you got those dynamics going on, you guys need to give each other some space. Okay. I don't know if the man is doing it or if the woman's doing it, but I got a feeling it's the man. Because I got a woman here and I feel like it's feeling too something. But for you single Capricorns, let's see what's going on. Compassion for all and be gentle with yourself. So you single Capricorns, listen, I saw that when I was shuffling earlier. I did shuffling before I came on and I shuffled again on the camera just to make sure that my spirit picks up everything as much as it can, as sure as it can. And right now, my motherfucking aura is kicking around this bitch, okay? Because everything that I did, it's been coming on when I'm trying to tell y'all. I ain't tuned my own horn. Be a natural beauty. I am in a way. And what's wrong with tuning your own horn? You know what? When I hear people talking about themselves and like, I'm this, I be happy. I be like, go girl. You know, I be all into it. When I see somebody like, I'm this, I'm that, I be into it. Like, yeah, go ahead. That's what you're supposed to be. You know, when people are like, oh my God, you're so vain. It's like, what's wrong with that? What if that person grew up with low self-esteem and now they finally have an opportunity? Forgiveness heals. You guys are dealing with something, you single people. You guys are dealing with something. Anyway, let me see which one. Notice the blessings for you guys that are single, came out. Notice the blessing, but be a natural beauty and compassion for all. I saw that twice. Notice the blessing, forgiveness heals. So listen, you single Capricorns. I don't know If you're still trying to forgive somebody from your past, because you do have released the past here. But forgiveness heals. Notice the blessings. I see a lot of butterflies. And Be a Natural Beauty came out for you single Capricorns. Notice the blessings. If you're just alone, like the Wolf Girl said, it's okay to be alone. Here she is. If you just ain't dating and you ain't got nobody, it's cool. You know what I mean? Like, notice the blessings. Be natural this month. I see a lot of my sisters dreading their hair up and natural locks and stuff. A lot of my sisters are, you know, Afro-American women. Or, you know, you ain't got to be black to wear dreads. But that's what just came to me. Forgiveness heals. For you single Capricorn, I believe that this is tying back to someone that you already left and you're single. Heal yourself as much as you can. And that one jumped out. Shit. Make waves. I don't know what that means for you single caps, but so what? Make waves. Shit. What the fuck was that? Okay, I'm getting a lot of crazy energy while I'm doing y'all. But anyway, so I just heard something. I don't know what the fuck that was. Like something. Okay. I've been getting a lot of crazy energy. Anyway, this all this shit is crazy. So why is this happening to Capricorns? What's the cause? What's the reason? What's the purpose? That all the things that I discussed here, why is this happening? This is your sentence, okay? This is your verdict. Oh, okay. Because there's indecision, that flew out. So whatever you guys are making being indecisive about, that is the cause and the purpose and the reason of why all these things are happening to you. I may not get another one. Damn, that's a damn lie. I got two more. I got to get them, y'all. They fell on the floor. Yin and yang, yeah. End the journey. Okay, I'm done with y'all. Okay, so listen. Carnicorpia, I'm not surprised. So listen, the reason why or the purpose or the cause of all these things happening to you is, where's my card? Did somebody fucking eat it? Indecision. I don't even know. Oh, here it is right here. I need to turn it over. Sorry, guys. I'm very distracted with you guys and very like antsy. I don't know if some of you guys got some OCD. Indecision. The purpose and the reason and the cause of a lot of things that have happened that's been discussed here is because of you've been indecisive, not knowing which way to go. It's on a number 8. It's a very powerful number. And don't beat yourself up about it. You know, if you took too long to leave that abusive relationship, well, it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? Or it is what it ain't, rather. You are on a journey. Some of you Capricorns that are feeling alone for no reason, you're on a journey. You know what I mean? And for those dealing with relationships, that yin and that yang, you're going to have to get that shit together. You know, this motherfucker that's trying to make you feel coy or wanting to beat you in submission, or Capricorns, if it's you, you know, I'm feeling like a lot of people are newly dating or thinking about getting married, because as soon as I picked up the yin and the yang card, I felt that energy. And you're trying to come together and you feel like you feel complete, but there's a part of you that ain't feeling some shit. There's a part of you, Cap, that's like, nah, I ain't with that, right? Watch these relationships, because I know last month you guys had some relationships that were really good that made you feel childlike, right? And you felt happy and you were in love and this and that and that and this, right? But that guy, this came in reverse. When I picked it up on the floor, it was down on the floor reverse. It flew out. That yin and that yang, y'all got to get that shit together, because this energy is different here. That coyness and submissiveness, I feel like, don't be the fucking fool, okay? Like, you may have been looking for this and you may have been looking for that, but I feel like somebody is trying to do something to y'all in a relationship that's coming through heavy and strong that you kind of like, no, listen to your intuition. You kind of like, wait, you know, like, he cool. I thought he was good, you know, blah, 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 blah. But now he's showing signs of borderline being abusive or not respecting your feminine wows. Okay. Somehow Hold on. I just heard a song. It caught my... What you know about that? Maybe I caught it because this is my song, y'all. But basically what she's saying is, I had this real low, but when I hear something and it makes me look, then I gotta... Oh, shit. That is my girl. Well, fuck it. We about to party. Let me get your sacred rebel card. I heard it out the corner of my ear. Yeah, you gotta tell this dude or whoever. Y'all, it's a wrap. Capricorn. It was very low, but it caught my attention. You guys are the new me. When I hear music or a song and I feel like it's for you, it's going down. It's going down, Cap. Yes, tell that motherfucker you want to feel him. You ain't trying to be lead into submission or, you know, love ain't about that. Love is a sharing, okay? So what y'all gonna do next? Based off all the shit we just talked and now that Samantha done came in? Yeah, get the song and tell them, like, walk with me together. You heard what she said. Walk with me together. All right? Get your yin and your yang right with y'all relationships. I want to feel you. Faith in the process for those that are going through. This is what to do next. You got faith as your Oracle Rebel card or Oracle Rebel. Hold on, let me turn this down because I'm going to be in talk. Listen, y'all. For those that are going through some shit that's on the journey, here's your card. Look, I'm anxious. I just want to hurry up. Faith in the process. Whatever you're praying about, whatever situation is in the journey or you're indecisive about, that's your Oracle Rebel card, okay? You got to work that out, y'all. Okay, and what you want wants you came in reverse. Now, this card, you have to be careful because people like to trick themselves. They think like, oh, I'm in love with this person, and so I want them. They want me. No, that's not what that means. That means be fucking careful, okay, about what you want and what you want wants you. Because if you're in an abusive relationship or you're in that mindset, you're not going to be clear. You're going to be indecisive about what you think you want wants you. No, don't be drawn in that energy. All right, Capricorn, I am Jupiter's Law. The verdict is in, and you're going to have to tell whoever. Look, we're going to have to get it. You better get that yin and yang right. You ain't that in love. Gotta go. I can't help it, y'all. Y'all get y'all. Somebody said I'm up too. Well, get your ass up there. Pipe your deck. I think I got a dance clip with this. Yeah, you need to get that shit right. You want to be like this with your feminine wow. Don't let nobody control you. Guys, I am just lost. Deuces. Love y'all. See y'all next month, maybe, perhaps.